between hockey and those other sports, you gotta be tough to be a hockey player. Hey, a blister never stops a hockey player, if you know what I mean. And that other sport, a slap on the wrist, a foul, give me a break. And remember, in hockey, you can't run out of bounds. You can run, but you can't hide. You ready? Let's go! Blue's all ready to go. You all set to go, Blue? Yes, she is. And this is where Blue and I watch 300 games. Tell them, Blue. Tell them all about it. Yeah. And listen, we watch 300 games here. And you know, the one thing that Blue and I remember last year, what really ticked us off, at the end of the World Tournament. You remember what they said about Gretzky? He was finished. Can you imagine that, Blue? Saying Gretzky's finished? I can't believe it. She was ticked off. I was ticked off. He's not finished. 72 points last year, or assists, what are you talking about? This guy, him and Mario, 72 assists. These guys were great. Watch a little of his magic right now.
Here's Wayne in his office behind the net. Luke's gonna miss him in LA, I'll tell ya. Oh no, not again. Where's the puck? Where's the puck? It's in the net, Jocelyn. Hey, here's a spot you don't see way too often. In that corner, mucking it up. Oh, I'm just kidding, Wayne. Here's another behind the net job. When are they gonna catch on? Hey, watch Wayne go and he'll get some revenge at the Olympics, I'll tell you. He's gonna show him. Watch and see. Well, here's the last hurrah for Mario. Take a gander at these beauty passes. You know, it's a funny thing. He had 50 goals and 122 points last season. He wins the scoring championship, and he said he had a bad year. If he had a bad year, what about the rest of the league? He like threading the needle. Hey, good luck on the golf courses, Mario. May all your drives be long and straight. You are a great hockey player. You've seen some great passes from Mario and Wayne. Now watch some brutal passes. We call these suicide passes. And a boy, Mike, a good Winnipeg boy. You can't keep them down. Hey, Jenny gets his bell rung here. And everybody thinks it's funny. Hey, let's take a look at that one again. Duchesne gives Alfredson a beauty suicide pass, and he comes to his rescue because he knew he made a mistake. Future Hall of Famer Hawachuk gets nailed by Constantine up in last year's playoffs. Hey, Vlad, we're all pulling for you. Hey, get better soon, and we want to see you right back in a Red Wing uniform soon.
Do you know how many shutouts there have been in the NHL this year?
I don't know.
49. The record 49. Is 99. We've got a minute and a half, so what do you? We might as well show these saves though. You went to all the trouble.
All right, I did all the shutouts. Let me tell you about right now. Let's go with Curtis Joseph. I got to hurry. 52 saves in one game. Watch this one with Detroit. 52 saves. And Mickey Redmond said, I saw the game, and Mickey said they give him an ovation. He was the number one star.
And now, some more great saves from Cujo.
Boy, he sure stole the stars in last year's playoffs. This is an OT in Game 7. It's the save of the playoffs. Hey, look what I found.
And Joe can't believe it.
Poor Felix had more shots to him last year than any other goalie. He saw so much rubber, they started to call him Mr. Michelin Man. One of my favorite Ottawa's little Ronnie Tugnutt. He sure did shine in the playoffs last year. Call this segment a little help from your friend. Hatcher with the save. Now watch Bruce Driver make a nice save here. Hey, he says, no way, no way. Some goalies kiss the post, and this is the reason why. Just listen. Hey, the post can't save you all the time.
This has got to be one of the hits of the century. And you're
you're laughing?
Well, it was funny in retrospect.
I think it's terrible. But, you know, how many times have you kids and you guys, I've said, never cut into center? How many times have I said it?
Lots.
100 times. Well, first of all, we'll start. Go ahead, Mark. Roll it. We'll see where we're going. My voice is going. I'm so
Scott
excited.
Scott Stevens on Slava
Kozlov. Scott, now you remember this one? This here coming up, watch this. Scott comes across. Scott's got to hit more like this. Remember that? Then he said to Dino, you're up. But he got up, I got to admit.
You got up nice wearing 13 the next time, you won't. Watch this here one now. This is a beauty. Neuendijk, wacko. Forsberg, give it to him. He's still out. Now, here he comes again. Don't be blind cutting across there. He's not cutting the center. He's cutting blind going the other way. Now, watch this one. Karpov, whoa. Stephen Rice, Kitchener boy, give it to him. Cutting into center. I guess the Russian said he's a Russian?
Yes.
Yeah, he can't understand. Now, watch
this.
It's
funny because one was involved in each, and at least Forsberg got one the other way.
Yeah, that's right. The Russians are always involved. Anyhow, what I'm saying, here it is again. Head down. Don't you kids do that. Because Stephen gave it to him pretty good. Did he give him an elbow penalty here, I think?
No, he didn't.
No way it was an elbow.
Ronnie Wilson was complaining that it should have been, but
no
more forearms.
Watch this here one. Keep your head up. Wacko. Way to go, Stephen. He's all right. Got a little buzz.
That was Thursday night.
Hey, you need more reason not to cut across center ice. Just watch these crunchers. Don't dive here, though.
Hey, folks, there's nothing like an overtime goal. I know you coaches and players are saying the same thing. I love it. I tell you, you're going another world. See this picture here? This is when Terry O'Reilly scored the second overtime in Philadelphia. I think it was 10-1 in the morning. And I hate to tell you, folks, he got on there by mistake. Bobby Schmatz should have been on there. I had called for Bobby Schmatz.
And were we happy. There's Mike Milbury jumping up and down Brad Park. Wayne Cashman comes to the thing. We were a happy group.
Then naturally, after the game, I said, well, I thought that was a brilliant move. Terry O'Reilly out there. Anyhow, here's some more overtime goals. I just love them.
Game 7 in OT, and Plant puts a tough one past Tugna.
Watch Ronnie look at his glove. I honestly think the puck went right through his glove.
You know, folks, there's nothing as high as winning in overtime. And nothing as low as losing in overtime. Here's that save again. You need these kinds of saves in overtime if you're going to win. And here's what happened right after it. Are they happy or what?
Drop pass by Lindgren to good guy Kelly Buckberger, and Kelly wins game 3.
Can you imagine winning 3 games in overtime in one series? And watch Ryan Smith, he zings it home for the winner. Hey, what a beauty goal.
You know, folks, someday somebody's going to get hurt during one of these celebrations. Watch coming nail teammate Krizakovov or something like that. Watch out!
Hey, watch Brisbane. Tell everyone he scored. Hey, it's me. It's me.
Hey, one of my favorites gets one here. Watch this second effort by Adam Graves. Way to go, Adam.
We'll be right back.
Hey, there's nothing nicer than a good glove save. Watch these. Ronnie Tugnutt with some beauty. Say there wasn't too many goalies run this year because of the crease rule. I don't know. Don't fool with Wendell. I tell you, folks, it's a tough spot to play. Dive. No dive here, though. Buffalo, Barnaby gives Tugnutt a little shot, and then the defenseman gets the penalty. Eric gets 2-for-1. Sandstrom, dive! Hey, not only did Felix see the most shots last year, he had the most hits. I'll tell you one thing, he doesn't pick his spots. Here he goes at it with Owen Nolan. And now we have Hextall at Potbat. Look at Clark go after Lacroix, gives him a couple of shots. And here comes Hextall. He's coming down after Potbat. Watch, there's Kirk there. He grabs Holler. Now watch in the background. Look at the fans in the background going nuts. Yeah, they say they don't like fights in the National Hockey League. Watch the little kid, the New York. Look at the little Toronto Maple Leaf guy here. Ronnie, get your head up. Get your head up. That's why you're getting your clock clean. Look at Potvin. Go, this guy can throw him. I'll tell you, boy. It's amazing how they can throw him with all that equipment. Now here is payback time in Detroit. Waz coming from the other end, and Shanahan hits him there. There they go. Boy, I'll tell you, this was a Pierre Sixter. You know what this was from? This was the time when Lemieux gave it to Draper, broke his head. Now look at these two guys go, boy. You got to admire Walk for coming down. Vernon for coming out. They could have set in their nets and, you know, take it easy. Boy, I'll tell you, two warriors there. I love them both. Strange things happen in hockey, folks. Hey, no wonder Dougie left. Watch this beauty set up by Pavel to Gino. Open net. Oh, did I really miss that? Modano to Reed, another wide open net. Mike thinks it's funny, but Davey doesn't think it's too funny. Hey, a few years ago, we showed Mike falling off a stretcher. Now we have Mike with his pants falling down. Hey, this is a Keystone Cops routine. Oh, the guys say that's embarrassing. Comes Chris Chilios. Hey, watch out for the blue light, Chris. Hey, every once in a while, the hockey players need to get their heads screwed on right. Hey, the refs and linesmen have a tough time, too. Get up, Nick. Get up, Nick. Get going. Get going. Ooh, that hurts. And he didn't even miss the call. Now for some great goals by one of the best hockey players to ever play the game, Stevie Wonder Yzerman. Is that pretty or what? Boy, Steve come up big in the playoffs. Watch this singer. Stevie, no wonder they won the cup. Watch these beauties from Pavel. Some goals by the Europeans just to show that I'm not prejudiced. Kaminsky with a Bobby Orr move. Marcus Naslin with a beauty spinorama. Here's Sergei. Here's Yammy. He's going to miss Mario the most. Here's Olin Nolan calling a shot at the All-Star game. He gets a hat trick in his home rink, and he doesn't get the car. Figure that one out. Here's another one of my favorites. Toronto's sure gonna miss Dougie this year. What a move. Beauty! Mats does his thing. Semenko's not around. Adam got thrown out of the game for helping Wayne. I don't understand it. You don't see much nicer ones than this. Beauty backhand by Conroy. Nice move by Manano. Martin tries for a goal here. And misses. Yeah, you know, you only try this when you're up by two goals. But he doesn't miss here. Strange goal by Francis. front of the air between his legs. And here's a goal to put the Rangers out of the playoffs. Nice backhand, Eric. Watch Sanderson cough up the puck to Joey. Smooth hands Kosher. Hey, top shelf, and they say he can only fight. Hey, the tough guys came through for the Wings in the playoffs. Top corner. Nice one, Darren. But here's the goal of the century. This is what you call a how's she going? This way, that way, this way, and in. This is a Stanley Cup winning goal, folks, and to top it off, Derek gives a nice little dance. Way to go, Darren. Well, here we are, the part of the Coach's Corner. You know, not easy doing Coach's Corner. Not everybody can do it, I'll tell you. Okay, let's roll them.
The Los Angeles Kings, I know you like this hockey team.
No, I don't like the hockey team. They got a guy, Kristich. Who's their leading
Chris,
scorer?
That's Kristich. That's Kristich.
Whatever it is, shut up. I'm talking about Kristich, his their leading scorer. If you got to hit these guys, you'll beat Los Angeles. Toronto, I don't know what's going on in Toronto. They got some problems there, but LA won in Toronto. But I'll tell you something, Ottawa comes out hitting and elbowing. You see, the Europeans will be gone.
Hey, that was Jim Ralph doing me, good looking guy, and Greg Millen doing what's his name? I got to admit, he does me better than me.
Yes, I think I look exceptionally good tonight.
A little reminder to turn our clocks back.
What do you mean by that?
You'll be in style. Anyway, you look good. You got a newspaper here from Hamilton.
Excuse me. I don't have much time. Anyhow,
lots of time.
All right. Here, and at the end, you tell me to hurry. Okay. Anyhow, what happened was... Oh, you're saying it already. Now, listen. If you ask me the question, let me answer it.
Yes, please.
All right.
All right. Now, listen. You think you look good tonight, do you?
Exceptional.
Well, where's your poppy?
Right there. What do you mean?
Oh, it's there. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Oh, you thought I didn't have a poppy on,
eh? I thought I couldn't recognize.
Oh, you thought you were going to get me. You never told me to have my poppy on. You thought I lost it.
No.
Never always have my poppy on like you people should have your poppy. That's why you're sitting in your living room in the bars having a pint on account of guys that did that. Tony Schneider. Now, we got time. I got to tell you a story. This is a pretty good story. Punch Imlach had come from the Quebec League, and he was coaching a general manager of Springfield Indians, believe it or not. So I was playing on the team, and Tony was a tough guy, and I was a tough guy. And to hurry this up, we got into it in the practice. We know we're going. A punch just let it go. And they were standing around watching us go, watching us go. You couldn't believe it. We're hoping somebody builds it up, breaks it up. So anyhow, it's over. And folks, if you've ever been in a fight, your hands just shake like that. You're so tired. The guys that fight, you know. So I put on my gloves, and I put on my other gloves, and somebody gave me the stick, and I'm standing at the blue line. If somebody passes the puck, I'm so weak it knocks the stick out. Tony's stepping over the boards, and he feels like this, and he feels he's cut. He goes, nah, and he comes running at me. Believe me, folks, fear will give you strength again. I got to ask you a question.
Good.
I am sick and tired of what's going on in hockey. First of all, we have the 72nd timeout. Now we don't have the tag-up rule. Now you got to call the offside. What in the world was the replay about that? We are sitting on pins and needles waiting for some guy up on TV that probably never played the game is going to tell us if the game is good. That guy's on TV more than me.
How many times were you knocked out?
I was knocked out about 10 times.
Rose says that explains everything.
Well, is that right? Rose said that?
Yes, she did.
Gotta get back there.
She's a knockout. Don Cherry in the Coach's Corner and Molson Hockey Night in Canada.
Once.
On the CBC, yes, I did. And I was mincemeat for it.
Very good advice. I know you were going to mention Brett Hull's old buddy,
week.
Oates. Just as well you had food poisoning. You don't want to be dealing with that. Well, you did have a baker involved. Don Cherry, Happy New Year in the Coach's Corner on... Happy New Year, I said.
So what? Keep going. You're doing all right. Keep going.
Molson Hockey Night in Canada.
Are you telling me happy?
Yes.
Now, Doug, Arva, and Elsie are still in Parry Sound.
Still in Parry Sound. We were up there last night.
Elsie, I'm the favorite with Elsie.
Grandma loves you. Yes. She thinks you're the only one that tells the truth.
Well, that's true. Everybody else loves me, too. Now, we have another goal. I had a lot of questions, but I know you want to see some nice goals. Watch this goal right here. If you don't say this is one of the best assists you'll ever see. Go ahead, Mark. Run this here one now. Watch this, Bobby. Do you remember this?
I'm going to talk over this one. Now watch, he's got him down. I didn't know. Now watch his elbow. Watch what he does with the elbow here. I think it's Johnny Busick over there, isn't it?
Yeah, it's Johnny in front of
him. Watch John. I think it's John going over there. Puts in one of his 500. Not bad, Bobby. Now, let's get... Last week I had Mueller. This is why I've been hurt.
And
the week before. Now, you kids out there, I know you can't do this, but look at the heart of this here guy. First of all, we're going to show you... I want to show the hit again with the puck. What was Dougie shooting? Go ahead, Mark. Roll it right now. Show it right now, the hit and everything like this. Now, there he is. Cut there. He come back. By the way, Dr. Douglas, now here's the shot comes out. I don't know what Gilmore was shooting at. He puts it out here, he comes to watch it. Dr. Douglas put in 25 stitches in 4 minutes, a record. He comes back, there it is again. Now, if you're ever going to bail, the score is 3-0, the crowd is booing. Let's say, I can't see out of my eye. That's what most guys would say. Let me see, and Dr. Douglas put it in. Here's what he does when he comes back. He's still in there banging and smashing. He gets caught. Watch coming back. He's got 25 stitches, blood running down his eye.
You ever cut this bad?
Oh, was I? I had 17 stitches in the eye one time. Looked like I had 3 eyes. Anytime he comes back, he tries to do it. And now watch him on the bench. Hey, Nedved said he worked with him last night. Look, is that a warrior? He'd take the bullet for you. Nedved said, I worked on his line. I got 3 assists, because if you don't, Kirk's all over you. A warrior and a hockey player. What? We're coming back
now.
No,
you got it. It's,
we're coming here. We got
consensual.
Something. This is consent. You were talking about consensual.
Last week.
Watch this coming up with Palfy and Green. I'm telling you, folks, it's lovers. I tell you. Watch this here now. Right on the lips. It's coming up pretty soon. Watch this. Watch it now. What's the next one coming
here
up?
Here it comes. Travis Green.
Here it is. Travis Green. It's coming over. Now, here's another reason not to wear the visor. Do you lean to the left or lean to the right? Now, I know guys with visors are sweeties, but
maybe look better after. Maybe look better after a glass.
Pardon?
Maybe look better after a glass, because, you know.
Oh.
Don Cherry, tongue-tied on this installment of the Coach's Corner, like Ziggy Palfy and Travis Green on Wilson Hockey Night in Canada.
Beautiful.
You know, just one other thing. The Sporting News, big publication here, had a story on Paul Laws of Florida. Great fighter. They said the other tough guys are Probert, Kasparaitis, and Al Samuelson.
Make you cry, doesn't it?
Yeah.
I mean, these guys are supposed to be hockey guys. Kasparaitis and Samuelson, fighters. Two turtle Russians. Anyhow, hey, now, you know, when the kids over, you know, we are so good. The women win. The women won theirs. We won the Spangler Cup. Under 17, Ontario beats Sweden 7-2 or 6-2 or something like that. We're so good. Now, while the kids are over there, we never show, you know, they get back and everybody forgets it. You know, and I said, I wonder what the headlines will be in our national paper or our paper here. Now, look at in the national paper here. Look at the headlines. You roll that little headline that we got here.
Don't read too much into Canada's junior hockey victory.
You know, this here, these people, how everybody thinks we have an inferiority complex, it's guys like this putting it in. We are the absolute topper. Nobody can talk. I was listening to a talk show 2 days ago saying how better the program, I know we got to get going, how much better the program is in Sweden. They won one game there, won one game in the World Tour. We are the best, kids. Listen to me. I'm a hockey guy. And as we go out, I hope you've all got the VCRs going, because this is Canada. I'm not going to say another word. This is Canada. Remember this.
Far and wide. they got cranked by Ulf Samuelsson in last night's OT loss to the Rangers. We saw it earlier on the telecast, but you got right up. Are you a little bit stronger than some people give you credit for?
Well, Mr. Chew is going to be happy. Maybe I will do the highlight on his video. Maybe I will do the front page or something. But no,
that's stuff. Rock 'em sock 'em quality, I think.
Exactly.
It sure was, Alexander. And here are some more Rock 'em Sock 'em Crunchers. Dive! Hey, Gardner says, I'm not going to take that. Simpson put out Forsberg a long time with this one. And good guy Jones jumps in to help like he always does. Ottawa and Buffalo were sure hitting the hurt in last year's playoffs.
Wait a minute, you kids, when a guy's got a hat trick and you got an open net, watch the Boston boy. I love him. He used to watch my Bruins play, Keith Tkachuk. Watch what he does to get Gartner his hat trick. Now watch it. Comes out. Now watch him look. He's looking for him. Intercepts the puck. Now watch him meander, as they say. Where is he? Where is he? Where's Mike? Come on, Mike. And Mike says, I didn't know what he was doing. That's the way to do it, kids. When you got a hat trick and you see a guy coming down, wait till that guy and give him for the hat trick. That's a good Canadian way. And I has Keith that he is a Canadian.
Hey, folks, let's listen to the sounds of hockey. Nice pass to Sanderson by Rice. Tick. Tack. Toe. Yes! Here's Amani with a few. Love his hair. Kuzinov catch the Rangers on a bad line change. Ooh, coaches hate that.
Dave, funny things happen in hockey. Way to take out McDonald's, Keith. Hey, I wonder if this is against the rules. I'll have to ask my buddy Brian Burke on that one. Hey, watch Ty straighten out Lemieux's bonnet. Hey, ref, he's picking on me. Look at him, look at him. Hey, kids, always keep a firm grip on your stick at all times. Isn't he sweet? Hey, if they still use wire, this wouldn't happen. Who are really no talent. You know, a lot of strange things happen around a bench. Chat. And Todd Ewing says, hey, Ty, how about a little cool drink? Belford says, sit down, I can't see the game. You know, they tell me they have to have the benches on the same side for TV. Yeah, we see things like this. A shot. Mark had a tough year last year, but he'll be back this year. Hey, Mike waves the towel and says, we surrender, among other things. Hey, you know, I'm often asked, which is the greatest minor league team that ever was? Well, I'll tell you, the 66 Oklahoma Blazers got to be ranked right up there. Look at these guys. Jean Pronovost, 50 goals in the NHL. Terry Crist, Stanley Cup champion with the Philadelphia Flyers. Glenn Saylor, how many championships did he win? Hey, Jean-Paul Parisi played on the 72 Canada-Russian series, played a long time in the NHL. Dick Cherry, my brother, played in the NHL. Wayne Cashman right now with the Philadelphia Flyers, captain of my Boston Bruins, what a guy. And look at the goaltenders. Dougie Favelle, long time in the NHL, and Hall of Famer Bertie Perron. Hey, those guys saw a lot of rubber, and so have these guys. You know, folks, if I was going in the seventh game in OT, Pat Roy is the guy I want in goal. That's what I call covering up the puck. You remember what I said? You can't run out of bounds? Watch. You know, folks, I'm often asked, who's the toughest guy you ever saw in the NHL? Well, that guy right there, that's John Wincink. I know you think that it's Derek Sanderson because he kind of looks like him. It's not. He was one of the toughest I ever saw. And that's us when we were in Boston at training camp. I think that was the year I won Coach of the Year. Anyhow, for you people that don't like fights, it's that time again. It's tea time because here we go. Let's go. And now it's Buffalo and T.O., two of my favorites. Look at the gloves go. Ty Domi and Ray, Rob Ray going. Now watch them go here. I can't understand how Ray's helmet stays on all the time. Ty, for some reason, never ever tries to get the other guy's helmet off. Now they're getting ready here. Now watch Ray. He grabs, he's getting ready because he's hit the tee, pulls it off. Ty never does that. The big thing about Ty Domi, he can switch. See him switch right there? His left is as good as his right, and that throws you off because, you see, Ray's got his right. Now he tries to switch over, but it's too late, and they jump in here. The linesmen do a good job here. They jump in. About this time last year, you notice he doesn't, the sweater doesn't come off because he'd be throwing out. This time last year, he'd be naked. Two good guys going. See the left goal with Ty? Now the linesmen jump in. Perfect. That's the way to do it. Now, he thumbs up, and now you go over to the bench and you see Ty. Hey, look at this here. Yeah, they love, they hate fighting in the NHL.
A lot of folks are upset when you show fighting.
Too bad. Don't watch then.
Okay.
Yeah, don't watch, but you'll be watching this one. Now watch. This is Cummings and my buddy Chris Murray. Now, you don't wonder why this one's on, other than that's a good little disagreement. Chris Murray says, I want to be on Rock'em Sock'em 9. Well, here you are, Chris. They're going to love him in Carolina. Nothing could be finer than to be in Carolina. Now, you're wondering why the helmet is. Look at Cummings has got a hold of his helmet. I'll tell you, these two guys went, well, you can't believe how tired you get in this. Now, watch Probert. He's getting excited on the bench a little early. Watch him come over and start hollering at him. Hey, gee, look, they're laughing, folks. They're laughing. Now, watch Probert. He doesn't laugh. That's Amani, and they're hollering there. And then he's back at him again. I'll tell you, two good guys. Hey, they're going to miss him in Montreal, but they're going to love Chris in Carolina.
Folks, thanks for watching Rock'em Sock'em 9. I hope you enjoyed it because Blue and I love bringing them to you. Now, listen, stay tuned. Blue, you're not bored here, are you? Stay tuned now because we got some tips for you parents. Hey, you think this is Theory and Flurry? No way. It's my grandson, Dell. Well, here we are in my basement. You know, Dell, I get letters from parents and ask me about kids, what they should do, what they shouldn't do. You know what I'm going to do right now? I'm going to, Dell, you listening to me? Yeah? Okay, he's listening. You listen to me out there, too. I'm going to answer all the questions that you asked me, all right? Right now. Okay, Dell? Yeah, Dell's ready. Give it a thumbs up, Dell. All right. All right, the first question I'm asked is, when should the kids start skating? You know, a lot of guys put them on at 2, some 2.5. I've heard them even a year. I don't like that. And I'm going to tell you why I don't like it. Dell is going to start skating at 3. I'm always afraid the kid will fall down, hurt himself, hit his head, and believe me, it's tough getting them back on the ice. Somehow, at 3 years old, they seem big enough, they can handle it, they understand what's going on. But I'll tell you what I do to help Dell. And if you take a look at this skate, this is the skate that he has. See how I put the tape on the bottom, nice and thick on the bottom here. And what happens is he walks around the carpet, he walks around, strengthening his ankles, getting the balance ready for the ice. Now, I go one step farther with Dell. You do this if you want. I take his laces out. He runs around. He actually runs around with no laces in his skates, strengthening his ankles. Get him on the ice at 3. If you want to go earlier, that's up to you. 3 years old. That's the one I like, boy. They're ready to go and they're hungry. Hey, they watch Coach's Corner and they're ready to go. 3 years old. Okay, the two things I'm asked, and people come in letters and they're asking me all the time, they say, what's the two most important things in a practice that we work on? I mean, you can work on a million things. Well, naturally, the first one is skating. You can't skate in hockey or finish, so you work on the skating. But the one that we don't work on the most, and I have to say the Europeans got us in that. When I was over with Team Canada in the World Tournament, I saw young kids practicing. They always handle the puck on every drill. We have it. We roar the kids up. We have them doing circles, jumping on one leg, over hoops, and things like that. The Europeans, what they do, every drill the kids have, they handle the puck. If I was running a practice for kids now, and I had a hockey school right now like I had in Boston, every drill, they handle the puck. Now, I know what you're saying. Well, they shoot the puck at the boards when they have it, or they lose it. That's okay. You got to discipline them that they don't shoot that at the boards. Handle the puck, naturally skate. Handle a puck. You can't play the game unless you can handle a puck. You see Gretzky, Bobby Orr, Mario, they can handle a puck. You can't just be banging the puck around all the time. Skate naturally, handle a puck every drill, and you'll be a hockey player. All right, the next question that's usually asked, should a kid play hockey all year round? You know, a lot of parents, they love it. They take them to tournaments in the summer, July, August. And, hey, they want to do that. The kid seems to like it. But me, I don't believe in it. I don't believe in a kid should play hockey 12 months of the year. Now, I'm not saying he shouldn't skate a little bit in the summer. I'm not saying he might even go to a tournament. But you can't play all the time. You got to have that hunger. When the fall comes, you smell the air and everything. Hey, hockey's starting. Bobby Orr says the kids are burnout. He's gone now. He sees kids starting in the fall. They're burnout. I agree with Gretzky. I agree with Orr. And we're experts. Don't play the kid 12 months a year. Have him when the fall comes. He said, boy, Dad, I can hardly wait. I can hardly wait till the season starts. That's the way you got to have him. Don't burn him out. Don't wear him out. Have him hungry all the time. Now the question is, should my son, from the time he's 4 and 5 and 6 and 7, play one position? You know, he's a goaltender, have him in the goaltender all the time. I don't believe that. I believe the kid, if he likes, you know, goaltender's sort of like a glamour spot and everything. Put him in there and let's see how he wants. You're going to say, yeah, what about the equipment? Some parents, they pay all the money for the equipment. They say, you're playing there, kid. He should try different spots. I know everybody likes to play center. That's the spot Mario and Gretzky, everybody. But they should try it all. I've heard of kids saying, oh, I'm playing defense. I'm back here. This is no fun. I want to go up forward. So they go up forward, and all of a sudden they don't get as much ice time. They don't like it. Try different spots. Don't let them just stay in one spot. You never know. You might have another Bobby Orr, or you might have a Gretzky. Different spots up until, I would say, 11 or 12. When he gets 11, 12, and 13, you better have him in one spot so he's learning the game. Don't keep him in one position. Let him play all the spots. Now, I know I said you shouldn't play hockey all year round, but you can practice. You know, I talked to Bobby Orr, Gretzky, Sakic, Esposito, the guys with the good shots, the guys that put it in. I said, you know, what do you do in the summer? Well, they don't like to tell you. What did you do when you were a kid? Well, most of them and all of the guys I talked to, especially Sakic, used to have linoleum. Is that how they say it down there? And he used to be down his basement, and he used to shoot pucks by the hour. That's how he got the wrist shot. All summer, bing, bing, bing. You know, you can get the net, put it there, bing, off the linoleum, pucks, bing, bing, bing. You work your shot, top corner, back and forth like that. You work on that. Now, the goaltenders. I see the goaltenders in the summer. They have some guy in the, you know, in the laneway, and they're wiring pucks at him. I wouldn't have that. This is what I'd do if I were you. I'd put my mask on. I'd put my block. I'd put my catcher and blocker and everything like that, and my stick. I'd have your buddy get a tennis ball. Get all the fuzz off. You know, you get the good old road hockey tennis ball. Get all the fuzz off and practice that. And practice your move, catching like that. That's good. I don't mind you doing that all summer. Esposito or Sakic especially, that's how they made it. If you're not dedicated, if you want to go out and fool around, why you got spare time? Go down the basement, take some shots, then you'll make it to the National Hockey League. When I had my hockey schools in Boston, I'd be there, and I'd have a parent come up beside me, and he'd say, Don, I think my son should go in a higher division. He's not being challenged. That's the word they use, challenged. And I'd say to the guy, look, let the kid have some fun. Don't move him up with the bigger guys. You won't be able to do his little tricks. Stay with his own age for a while. Let him have some fun. Don't put him up too high, because what happens is he plays it safe. He doesn't want to try that little trick going around a guy because he's going to get nailed by the bigger guys. I remember one time, and it broke my heart to see it. I never forgot the kid's name. His name was Brown. He was a little goaltender. He was in his own division, and he was dynamite. And the mother kept coming to me all the time. I don't feel he's getting the shots he should get. And I said, look, man, leave him where he's having fun. Look at him out there. He's having so much fun. Yeah, but he's not being challenged with better shots. So this went on day after day after day. She got on my nerves. I says, you want him in the higher division? Says, yeah. He goes in the higher division. I'll never forget the first morning. The bigger guys were going in on him. They were wiring him in the top corner. I wouldn't let him get hurt. They were wiring him in the top corner, like I said, along the ice. Broke the kid. The poor kid started. I could still see him lying on the ice crying. I looked at the mother and I said, you see what you've done? I moved him down. I put him down, but the kid was never the same the whole school. I'm not saying if you see a big kid and you want to move him up and he's okay like a defenseman, but if he's a little kid, don't put him up in the bigger guys and let him get nailed. Let's be a big fish in a little pond than rather throwing him up and getting his brains pounded out, okay? Let him have fun, keep him in his division, and he'll improve a lot more. I hear parents complaining all the time, oh, my son's playing on a losing team, they haven't won a game in 10 games and that. Instead of saying, I want to say, well, how's the kid doing? Never mind how the team's doing at that age. You know, it's ridiculous to hear people talking like that, and they say, well, my son got 5 shutouts in a row. And I said, well, how many shots he get? Well, he's only got 10 shots a game. Then I hear another parent say, oh, my son had 10 goals scored on him. And I said, well, how many shots on him? He said, well, he had 60 shots on him. That's the kid that's improving. You don't worry. Hey, I like to win. Don't get me wrong. I love to win. But the thing is, the kid's got to improve. Never mind that you've lost 10 in a row. Is the kid improving? Never mind that his average is 10. Is he improving? That's the name of the game. Never mind the team winning. Is the kid improving? Now, I'm not saying you want to lose. Don't get me wrong. I know what you're saying. Long as the kids get the ice time, don't worry if your team is winning or losing, long as the kid improves. I'm often asked, should I put my kid in a travel team or the house league? Now look, if he's good enough to play on the travel team, I believe in the elite. A lot of people, oh, we don't believe in elite. I believe the kid's good enough to play and he's taking a regular shift. I love travel teams. But if he's not taking a regular shift, he should be in the house league. And I'll tell you a story. When I lived in Rochester, New York, my son was with the travel team. And I remember I traveled all the way from Rochester to Buffalo to see him play. He sat on the end of the bench, and he opened and closed the door the whole time. So I didn't say anything to him then. We drove back, you know, and they get the jackets, the travel team and everything. I remember sitting him down and saying, look, Tim, you can't play on that team. You're not improving. And I remember him crying, you're going to take me off. I remember him saying, you're going to take me off the travel team. I said, I'm taking you off the travel team, and I'm putting you in the house league. Well, his heart was broken, but he went. And I'll tell you a strange thing. He got his regular ice time. He proved. And the travel team come back to him for the end of the year and asked if he could go in the playoffs with him. I said, no, I'm sorry, you can't. You didn't want him at the start. But he was a little ticked off at that one, too. But he improved. If your son is with a travel team and he's playing, fine. But if your son is with a travel team and he's not getting the ice time, you're better off having him in the house league when he can play. No, there's one more thing I'd like to say before I leave. And the one thing I should put it under the headline, how to handle your kid when he's having a tough time. Or when he's having a good time. I remember I was standing outside the arena one day and a kid got a hat trick and he says, what do you think of that, Dad? He says, you should have had four. And I thought, broke the little kid's heart. You could see him go down like that. You know, you can get a lot more with honey than you can vinegar. And it's sad to see parents constantly harping at the kids all the time. You should have done this. What a mistake. You should let that goal in. It's brutal to hear it. And then, you know, I see the kids, and that's how they get out of hockey. That's how they get out of any sport. Now, I'll tell you a story of how my dad handled it with me. I was going to make the Boston Bruins. I was 15 years old. I was playing Junior B. I was going to go to Barrie Flyers and everything. And Harold Cotton, the number one scout for Boston Bruins, was coming to Kingston to see me. Well, you guessed it. I played the worst game of my life. I mean, I was heartbroken. So I figured that's it for my hockey career. And that's all I lived for was hockey. And I went home, and I remember walking home in the winter, and I had tears rolling down my eyes. There goes my career. And I'm very, very discouraged. And I remember my dad was laying in bed reading. I can still see the glasses down here. And I went in, and I wasn't crying then. He'd laugh at me. But I walked in. I said, well, I guess I blew it, Dad. I didn't play. I played awful. I was the worst guy on the ice. And he says, well, I've seen you play better games. But what about the time you blocked that shot? Yeah, well, what about the time you took that guy out in the corner? And what about the time you stood up? What a time you went out and nailed that guy at center ice? And you know, I think he picked out the four things I did the whole game. But by the time I left that room, I was ready to go. I thought I played the best game. And you're going to say, I know what you're saying now. Well, what do? You tell the kid every game he played a good game. But if you see he's trying to play his game, that's the key there. That's the word, trying. You're not going to play your best all the time. But if the kid's trying out there, don't be constantly harping at him. Always praise him if he's trying. Now, there are some kids that need a, you know what I mean, once in a while to get him going. That's okay. But if you see your son's doing his best and trying his best, that's enough. Don't be criticizing. Like I've said before, keep it fun. The Boston Bruins, I'm going to tell you, the Boston Bruins, I call an optional practice, and they'd all come. You know why? Because they were fun. That's the name of the game, folks. Hey, Dell, did you like that? Yeah, he liked it, and I hope you liked it, too. Hey, thanks for watching Rock'em Sock'em. I hope the advice helped you. Dell and I are so happy to bring these to you. He does look like Therian Fleury, doesn't he? Okay, Dell, let's give him the thumbs up, just like that. All right, folks, see you next year, God willing. Atta boy, Dell. The main thing for the kids is when you have a practice, when you have everything, they have fun, because that's the name of the game, right, Dell? Fun. Let's give it thumbs up. No, you got to go like this, Dell. Go like that, okay? Next time I see you like that. No, you're too good. Dell's good, boy. What a TV guy.
All right.
Yeah. You know, the second thing I'm asked all the time is when I have a practice and we're out there, what's the two things that... No, don't move, eh? When you... Yeah. Don't move.
Kind of, but your hands are really...
On the front?
Face.
Okay. Yeah,
so
yeah, I know
it's... Kind of
okay. No, I'm often asked to, oh, I say that all the time. Now the question is, now I know I, you ready?
Yeah.
Now I know I said you can't practice, oh. I'm having a tough time saying no. Now I know I said you shouldn't play hockey all year round. You know, I hear parents say all the time, you know, no, how did I start off? You know, I hear parents all the time saying, you know, my see what happens when I do it a second time? Stanley Cup champion. Terry Crisp, Stanley Cup champion with the Philadelphia Flyers. Glenn Sather, how many times?